Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Coach Craig Sports. Today is Tuesday, so this is the Waiver Wire episode for week number 14. It is not a very good Waiver Wire week in general. I'm not going to, you know, lie to you guys and say it's awesome or anything like that. There's some pieces out here to look at. Not anybody that I'm really looking at plug-and-play starters for the most part, but I'm going to list them all off. At this point in time, I'm not going to do the FAB percentages. If you guys have a question about that, you can let me know, just because every league and every situation is just a little bit different at this point in time, because you're either in the last week of the regular season or some leagues already started the first week of the playoffs as well. But we're going to start off with a couple quarterbacks. So I got Cam Newton coming off a bye in week 13. Rostered in 35% of ESPN leagues, 29% of Yahoo leagues. Decent chance that he's out there. Has a very easy matchup against the Atlanta Falcons. I know he played very poorly the last time out, but you know he was playing against a little bit better defense than the Miami Dolphins at that point in time as well. Should be a little bit easier matchup. A guy that you can at least stream this week and maybe pay off for you overall. Then we got Jimmy Garoppolo once again. This is probably the hardest remaining game he has left on his schedule against the Cincinnati Bengals in week 14. But last week in week 13, he was 20 out of 30, 299 yards, 2 touchdowns, 2 interceptions, 19.96 points in week 13. Rostered in 14% of ESPN leagues, 32% of Yahoo leagues. Decent chance that he's out there. And then after this week, his schedule, like for the playoff stretch, is very, very easy. And it could be very favorable, especially, you know, like even this week, if Elijah Mitchell doesn't play because he's dealing with a concussion, Jeff Wilson Jr. dealing with a knee injury, they might have to throw the ball just a little bit more. Maybe he gets Deebo Samuel back this week, maybe he doesn't, but, you know, George Kittle looked very good last week. Brandon Ayuk kind of disappeared a little bit, but he's still a decent player overall. So Jimmy Garoppolo definitely could do a lot worse than him at quarterback this week and going forward. Then we're going to move over to running backs. There is not like one that particularly stands out to me, so I want to highlight some handcuff running backs and their roster sit percentages. So Devontae Booker is going to be the first one for me. He's rostered in about 29% of ESPN leagues, 28% of Yahoo leagues. I believe Saquon's a little bit banged up already, but if he were to miss at any point in time, Devontae Booker is obviously going to be somebody you want on your team. Khalil Herbert, rostering about 20% of ESPN leagues, 14% of Yahoo leagues. If something, God forbid, happens to David Montgomery once again, if you're the David Montgomery owner, you probably want to have Khalil Herbert on your team because we've seen him be effective when he was the primary ball carrier. For the San Francisco 49ers, I do have Jeff Wilson down. He has a little bit of a knee soreness or something at this point in time, and nothing I'm majorly concerned about. But, you know, if Elijah Mitchell is unable to go this week, he could be the primary beneficiary. Maybe even Jamichael Hasty if Jeff Wilson and Elijah Mitchell are both unable to go. In terms of Jeff Wilson, 19% roster on ESPN, 25% on Yahoo. Decent chance that he's out there as well. Samaje Perine's definitely one to consider as well. Rostered in 7% of ESPN and Yahoo leagues. Joe Mixon did get a little bit banged up towards the end of that game. I think he'll be okay to play this week, but definitely somebody worth stashing just in case something happens to Joe Mixon or he's unable to go this week. Then last but not least on this list, I'll mention a couple other guys as well. I do have Mike Boone. So Melvin Gordon banged up. If he's unable to go once again, then obviously we saw Mike Boone be okay behind Javonte Williams. But if, God forbid, something happens to Javonte Williams as well, then Mike Boone would be somebody that you want to have in your lineup overall. Not the biggest one, you know, a stash, a dart throw type of guy more than anything at this point in time. Rostering 6% of ESPN leagues and apparently 0% of Yahoo leagues. But with that being said, too, if you're in a shallower league and guys that are high-value handcuffs that are rostered most leagues, you know, like an Alexander Mattison, a Tony Pollard, a Sony Michel, somebody like that, if they're not rostered in your league, they should definitely be rostered at this point in time. You could also look at Carlos Hyde, too. James Robinson's really banged up at this point in time. He's been limited. Maybe Carlos Hyde helps you down the stretch. Probably not going to be the case, but it's something that's out there at the very least. And then you could look at the Tennessee Titans running back situation, but Jeremy McNichol should be back this week. Then you have Hilliard, McNichols, Foreman. They all have had kind of flashes at times this season, but I can't trust any of them on a weekly basis. So if you want to go take that shot, that's completely up to you, but it's not something that I would recommend personally. Then we're going to move over to wide receivers. I know a name that's pretty popular this week too is Russell Gage. He's not on my list per se. I don't have anything against him, but he's just been super inconsistent. I know he's had a couple good weeks in a row now, but does that continue? We'll have to see. But we're going to start off with my first pick in Amon-Ra St. Brown for the Detroit Lions. Played 96% of snaps. He's been playing a ton of snaps lately. He had 12 targets, 10 receptions, 86 yards, and one touchdown in this game. 24.8 points in week 13. Very involved in this offense overall. 7% roster on ESPN, 6% in Yahoo. He goes against the Denver Broncos in week 14. Not the most favorable matchup by any means. So probably a guy that you want to pick up, stash for your playoff run, maybe use him down the stretch. Probably not somebody that I'm willing to throw out right away this week because it is a tough matchup. But if you really need to go there, I don't think it's the worst thing in the world either. Then, obviously, one of the bigger names this week is going to be KJ Osborne. Obviously, Adam Thielen hurt his ankle in this past game very early on in the game. So, KJ Osborne ended up playing 92% of snaps, 7 targets, 4 receptions, 47 yards, and a touchdown, 14.7 points in Week 13. Rostered in 4% of ESPN and 4% of Yahoo leagues. Goes against the Steelers in Week 14. Not the best matchup, but not the worst matchup either. At the same time, when you're looking at KJ Osborne, probably a guy that you can roll out right away this week, especially if Adam Thielen's not able to go. I believe this is the Thursday night football game as well. So probably the top wide receiver add overall this week is going to be KJ Osborne. Then last but not least, in terms of wide receivers, I do have Josh Reynolds, another Detroit Lions wide receiver, played 83% of snaps this past week, 7 targets, 4 receptions, 69 yards, 10.9 points in Week 13. We've seen him have back-to-back double-digit points. So if you need a wide receiver 3, a flex play that you just need somebody to throw in there, you could definitely do a lot worse than Josh Reynolds. Rostered in 3% ESPN leagues, 4% Yahoo leagues, pretty good chance that he's out there. Goes against the Denver Broncos in Week 14 as well. Same matchup as Amon-Ra St. Brown. Not the most favorable one overall because he's going to be going against Patrick Surtain II or potentially Ronald Darby as well. So a little bit hesitant there. I think if I'm chasing Lions players this week, I would love to have TJ Hockenson in his matchup. But both these guys are viable. Both of them could be useful down the stretch as well. Then moving over to the tight end position, we got Tyler Conklin. Obviously, this one comes from the Adam Thielen injury as well. He played 95% of snaps this past week, 9 targets, 7 receptions, 56 yards, 12.6 points in Week 13. These are all very good numbers for a tight end. This is going to be a weekly tight end one if you get these type of numbers. Roster in 34% of ESPN leagues, 30% of Yahoo leagues. Goes against Pittsburgh in Week 14. Not a very good matchup for tight ends in general. Pittsburgh's been pretty tough on tight ends. But if the volume is there, if Dalvin Cook's not able to go, if Adam Thielen's not able to go, the ball's got to go somewhere. And they're going to have chances for Tyler Conklin and KJ Osborne, as well as Justin Jefferson, who's obviously going to get a ton of opportunities as well. Then last but not least, at the tight end position, we have Gerald Everett. He played 77% of snaps this past week, 6 targets, 4 receptions, 7 yards. He actually ended up fumbling the ball twice in this game and losing it. So he only ended up with 0.7 points in Week 13. You're like, Craig, why are you talking about a guy that had less than a point? Because Gerald Everett, this was supposed to be a tough matchup anyways against the 49ers. It was a little bit easier just because, there was no Fred Warner, there was no Dre Greenlaw at linebacker, but still not a very advantageous matchup in general. 7% rostered on ESPN, 29% in Yahoo leagues. Goes against my Houston Texans in Week 14, and the Texans have struggled very mightily against the tight end position. Could be a very good week for Gerald Everett, a decent streaming tight end overall this week. Then last but not least, we're going to talk about the defenses. So first off, we're going to start off with the New Orleans Saints. They play against the New York Jets this week. Saints defense is pretty good overall. Jets offense, not the best overall. So this is a favorable matchup. It's about a 50-50 shot whether or not the Saints are out there. They're rostered in 49% of ESPN leagues, 45% of Yahoo leagues. So it's kind of a coin flip. Same thing with our next team, Denver Broncos, who are playing the Detroit Lions. Should be a favorable matchup since Denver's defense is pretty good. Detroit Lions, they won this past week, but they're not that great of a team overall. And the Broncos defense is rostered in 44% of ESPN leagues, 46% of Yahoo leagues. So once again, kind of a coin flip whether or not they are out there this week. Then we move down to the Los Angeles Chargers. Yes, they've really struggled in terms of run defense this year. They've given up points. They haven't been the best defense overall. But they do go against the New York Giants this week, who do not have the best offensive line. Daniel Jones, quarterback, maybe. Otherwise, it's going to be Mike Glennon. Very depleted offense in general. So could be a very favorable matchup for this Chargers team overall. Definitely have some upside there. Rostered in 7% of ESPN leagues, 26% of Yahoo leagues. Pretty decent chance that they're out there this week. And then last but not least, this one pains me to say just because it's against my favorite team, the Houston Texans. Seattle Seahawks defense, which honestly isn't that good, but they are playing against the Texans. Tyrod Taylor is hurt at this point in time, so we could see Davis Mills once again. Davis Mills is not a viable starting NFL quarterback, at the very least at this point in time. I don't think it'll ever be the case, but that's a whole other story for a different day. Seahawks defense going against a depleted Texans team overall on an offense that wasn't that good to start with Davis Mills at quarterback, is definitely going to be a favorable matchup. And that Seahawks defense is rostered in 6% of ESPN leagues, 13% of Yahoo leagues, so pretty good chance that they're out there this week. But with that being said, that's a quick little rundown on the Week 14 waivers. If you guys have any questions related to waivers at all, be sure to leave them down in the comments. Who's available? Who you're thinking about dropping? How much fab you have left? How much should you spend? If you have any specific questions to waivers, please do not hesitate to leave them below, and I'll answer them as quickly as possible. But with that being said, if you are new to my channel, please consider subscribing. Definitely would appreciate it. It helps to build the community that we're trying to build here at Coach Craig Sports, which is one that's truly for you, the viewers, helping you with your fantasy football teams, helping you with DFS, whether it's NFL or NBA. And then with that being said, if you are new or current subscribers yet to do so, also be sure to hit that notification bell down below. It's going to let you know every single time I post up a new video. If you haven't been around for a while, I post up 11 to 12 videos a week, daily NBA DFS videos, 4 to 5 days of fantasy football or NFL DFS content. So make sure you're subscribed. Make sure you have that notification bell turned on so you never miss a beat. But with that being said, that's all I have for today's video. Hopefully you all enjoyed. And then last but not least, special shout out to each and every one of you watching today's video. I truly do appreciate you taking the time out of your day to watch this video. Definitely means a lot to me. And I hope each and every one of you has a great rest of your day.